And if you were with me tonight, I'd sing to you just one more time. Song for a home.
Welcome, everyone. I'm Donna Godfrey, the principal of Caledonia Regional High School, and it is my honor to pause with each of you as we remember. Each year, we are proud to host a Community Remembrance Day service within the walls of Caledonia Regional. This year, there are restrictions in place for our protection and risk mitigation measures due to what is the global pandemic of COVID-19. Although our acts of remembrance may look different, they still have a powerful impact. Our students are watching this in their classrooms. Some are in their classroom with their teacher. Some are at home following a distance learning plan. Some of you are watching this online. I invite you all to pause, reflect, and remember with Caledonia Regional High School. On Wednesday, November the 11th, 2020, the 11th month, the 11th hour, and the 11th day, our nation will observe a moment of silence to remember those who fought and died for our country and for our freedom. At Caledonia Regional, we remember. We will now lay wreaths in remembrance. Lily McDonald will lay a wreath on behalf of middle school students at Caledonia Regional High School.
There's no one in town I know.
Brianna McNaught and Lauren Harrison will lead on behalf of the high school students at Caledonia.
I never said thank you for that. I thought I might get one more chance. What would you think of me now? So lucky, so strong, so proud. Never said thank you for
Mr.
that.
Mr. Patterson will lay a wreath on behalf of staff of Caledonia.
May angels lead you in. Here you meet my friends. On sleepless roads, the sleepless go. May angels lead you in.
Nicholas Morrow and Jackson members of the 560 Army Cadet Program, will be in the same bubble and then lay a wreath on behalf of the kids.
So what would you think of
me? And now, here's the escorts. A grade 11 student at Caledonia Regional High School will share with us an original letter entitled, My Dearest Rose.
My dearest Rose, sand and dirt blow into my eyes, making it difficult to see my enemies ahead. The sun is bright enough to make me sweat, although that could possibly be my nerves. The enemy approaches vastly over the horizon, and I know I have to pick up my gun and aim at a target. I shed a tear as another grenade goes off, indicating I have lost some of my brethren. Before I have the chance to shoot, a bullet has already met me. I lose all my energy and collapse unwillingly, only thinking of my dearest Rose as I lay my blood so close. The gunshot sent closer than before, although it's so hard to tell over the commotion that is happening above me as I slowly lose consciousness. I watch as some people in uniform fall beside me, leaving clouds of dust as they fall. Everything is cloudy, my vision growing weaker. I only see the bottoms of people's shoes and either hear the yelling of other soldiers or the bullets leaving the gun to hit into others' flesh. I try to find the energy to speak even though no one can hear me. I manage to muster up the energy to say, take care of my dearest Rose. And without any other words, I shed a tear, close my eyes, and accept my fate.
Thank you for that. Now I never have a chance. May angels lead you in.
In Flanders fields, the poppies blow, between the crosses, row on row, that mark our place, and in the sky, the larks, still bravely singing fly, scarce heard amidst the guns below.
We are the dead. Short days ago we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders fields.
Take up our quarrel with the foe, to you from falling hands we throw the torch.
Be yours to hold it high, if ye break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep, though poppies grow in Flanders fields.
Wouldn't let it live. May angels lead.